Good evening. We are taking a look at the EATON whole house, or business, if I suppose, surge suppressor. This is the CHSPT2SURGE, and we're going to also open it up. I'll let you just read the specifications, no need to repeat, unless you want the video to drag on longer. This would be considered a type 2 device. Grab a screwdriver. And this connects directly in your main breaker box. It is an all-weather device, all-weather enclosure. You can see on the screw there, it's a little hard to focus on it, but there is a rubber sealing grommet on there, or washer. So this can be mounted indoors or out. For outdoors, as long as you use an appropriate conduit. And our first look inside the box. This is a Varistor-based surge suppressor. And a Varistor is those little blue pucks. There's four of them in this specific one. Two for each leg of the 240 volts. So one side does 120, the other side does the other 120, and together it covers your 240. Well, it should be somewhat self-explanatory. And what a varistor does is think of it like a pressure release valve, you could say. And when the voltage being the quote-unquote pressure, gets too high, it will start bleeding the current off, or that power off to ground, hopefully. I was originally curious and wanted to open one of these up just because it was so darn light. And I still have a hard time believing these things can handle the amount of power they claim with such small size. Now, the varistors used on this one are made by Sincera, and the model is a T25D241K. And I will have a link to both that in the description box below. The link will be to the data sheet. And I will also have a link to a nice article on howstuffworks.com telling you or explaining in more detail about how a metal oxide varistor, or MOV, M-O-V, works and diverts the extra voltage. Now, you can see by the LEDs, we'll get a better look in a minute. I forgot to zoom out on this part. You can see the threads for mounting. You can also mount it directly to a box, and there's also a flush mount kit. And focus you. And you can see where the things are labeled, such as, now of course I flip it over. I'm going to unscrew that. Need a different bit though. Now, if you see to the left of the LED, there's a little spot that says D2. The D2 and the R2, there's one on each side, and that is for powering the LED, as the LED needs both direct current and a very low voltage. So that resistor is a 77 ohm at 5%. I'm not sure exactly what the 5% means. I'm not too familiar with resistors. But that's what DigiKey reported back based on the color code. That would be a violet, orange, gold. The colors are a little off on the camera. And the D2 is a rectifier. Well, that makes your DC. So between the resistor drop in the voltage and the rectifier, the LED is lit. I will also note the metal oxide varistors are also thermally protected. A little thermal fuse in there, one of those bumps. There we go, a little zoom out action. Don't have my usual work table available at the moment. And I just wanted to pull that up to see exactly if there's anything else underneath. And there's nothing. Put her back together. What's really interesting is the build cost should be extraordinarily low on these, so nice high profit margin. Most of the money you're paying for these is going to the UL testing, for one, liability, and I guess you're paying for the warranty in a nice pretty package. Some things to note for the surge suppressors. You want a MOV that cuts in at a lowest possible voltage, or as close to your operating voltage as possible. And this is one of the lowest on the market. So this one, it will cut in when the overvoltage reaches about 150 volts from line to neutral and 300 volts from line to line. That's pretty good. Now, the instructions on the inside say a 20-amp 2-pole breaker for this version, and a 50-amp 2-pole for the Ultra version. However, the outside of the box says you get the 5 kilovolt ampere rating when you use a 50-amp breaker on this. So that's what I will be using. It's also rated at 1,890 joules. In just a second here, we'll get a photo, zoomed-in photo, for you to get a little better close-up look. So it is a nice little package. I hope it really does what it claims. And I will also have a link in the description box below of where you can purchase one. Most hardware stores, Menards, Lowe's, Home Depot, they're about around $100, but link for about $55.